Welcome to On Point. This show is produced by the students in South's television production program and explores one topic of interest with one special guest. Today we're looking at Bring Your Own Device, and our guest is Chris Stanley, our Director of Instructional Technology. Chris, thanks for being here today.
Happy to be here.
Well, tell us first, can you define Bring Your Own Device? What is that for those who might not be familiar with the term?
Yeah, absolutely. So Bring Your Own Device, what it essentially is it's preparing an environment for your students to be able to bring their own technological equipment from home.
Okay.
So whether that's a Chromebook, whether that is a MacBook, or any other type of laptop, they're able to bring it to school.
Okay. So how will that transform and enhance the learning environment?
Well, when students are able to bring their own device into the classroom, what it really does is it adds one more resourceful tool to really enhance the learning that's already occurring in the classroom.
Okay.
So a teacher is obviously the instructional leader in the classroom, and there's a lot of great instruction that's happening there. The students then are able to collaborate with each other, and they can work on projects and even turn in assignments because they have the device with them.
So that brings up an interesting point. Essentially, why mess with success? We've been very successful in a very traditional classroom. Why do we want to introduce this element? What will it bring to our students?
Well, I think there's many reasons why we'd want to bring something like this into our district. Obviously, we are an extremely successful district, and we've been doing that for many years here. But we want to prepare our students for the future. And what we know is people in business and in many other types of jobs, they're not just working at their desk anymore. A lot of people, they could be working from home, and also people collaborate with each other in many different ways than they have previously. So one of the reasons why we like to include this into the classroom is we really want to normalize technology as well. We want students to feel comfortable with the ability to work on a presentation together, whether it is face-to-face or allow them to work from each other's homes too, but still working on that same goal.
And isn't that also preparing them for colleges?
Yeah, absolutely. Okay. And so one of the things that we know is that colleges have been using a learning management system for several years, okay. I'd say going on 15 years. And so to allow our students to have that comfortability to dive in and really learn what that environment could be like, I think that's really going to help our students out.
What about pushback? Are there people that are saying, why?
Yeah, I think anytime you have something new, a new initiative, you might get some apprehension from time to time, and I think that that's normal. What that apprehension allows us to do is really think why we want to be using something like Bring Your Own Device as well, too. It's important for us to listen to why some people might be apprehensive, but it's also important for us to continue speaking the message of the importance of using technology on a basis as to when it's important. I think it's important to share also that technology is just a tool, just like many other items that are out there as well, too.
Well, you spoke about listening. So how is it that you've listened to staff and to parents as you develop this initiative?
Well, as we got started, we're doing just sixth grade this year. And it was important for us to be able to work and prepare with our teaching staff before this was rolled out. So we've had many different professional development opportunities where we've brought our sixth grade teachers in, because we know that they, as the masters of instruction in their own classroom, they truly know what's going to be best in their specific class.
Okay.
So teachers have worked with each other as a department and created digital learning goals as a whole. We also had a parent night in the beginning of January as well, too, to not only discuss what this rollout would be looking like, but to address any concerns that families might have as well as we move forward with it.
So let's talk quickly about where does it roll out from here. We've started with sixth grade. What comes next?
Well, after the success of the sixth grade, we want to look at how do we continue this. And so beginning in the 1920 school year, we want to open this up to the entire middle school as
okay.
a whole. So sixth grade, seventh grade, and eighth grade. And then looking to the future as well, too, we're looking to bring that to the high school.
Perfect. Well, thank you so much for giving us the quick little tidbits. Is there anything else that you would want to stress as we talk about this transition to a more digital platform and enhancing our learning environment with that?
Sure. I think when it comes to the use of technology, it's important to know that we always want to have a balance, right? We know, obviously, that relationships always come from teaching instruction and working with students. And so we never want to eliminate that. The use of technology, we know that there's always a time and a place for it. So teachers have been looking at their learning goals and saying, what can I add here? And should I add something here as well too? So that's always going to be important for us to take a look at.
Nice. And so when you're talking about balance, that brings up one more question I want to make sure I cover, because it's something that parents have asked. How do we make sure that we're not overemphasizing screen time in our homes as well as at school? What can we do as parents to help support what you're doing and make sure that we're monitoring as well?
Sure. Well, again, like we do in the classroom, I think it's going to be important for us as educators to always be aware of what we're asking our students to be doing, and to know that they shouldn't always be on their devices at all time. And I think that's going to be important as we do that at home as well too. As a family, I think working together, and just like parents do with working with their students with homework, it's also going to be important for them to see and discover what they're doing in the classroom as well.
Nice. And this will give us another opportunity to have a lens into the classroom, which we might not have now.
Absolutely.
That's exciting. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for stressing balance and for helping us as we move along this path. And thank you for tuning in to learn about what we're doing with Bring Your Own Device in the Grosse Pointe Public School System. If you have a topic of interest you'd like to see covered in On Point, please don't hesitate to reach out. Email schoolboard@gpschools.org. Thank you.